Back in December 2020, I reviewed the spin-off title of my beloved Spider-Man PS4 and gushed for 6 minutes about how amazing the game was when it was brand new and one of the first games to introduce me into the next generation of gaming. I absolutely loved it, even more than the PS4 game and its DLC, thinking it was one of the greatest games of all time and a truly exemplary effort on the new PS5 console. And seeing as how I put it at number 8 on my top 10 favorite games of all time list, I clearly still love it. But why? Well, that's why this video exists. A major thing that sets Miles Morales apart from most games, and even the original Spider-Man in many cases, is the way it's animated, as you effortlessly glide around in the air, whack enemies, bash and bang around with your special moves, and rush through the city, you feel an overwhelming sensation come over you. The first game had great animation that really brought the world to life, but Miles Morales makes that look like it's one frame per second, because it seriously bests the animation of almost every other game I've seen, despite still having a realistic style. Games like Mario Odyssey and A Hat in Time are cartoonish wonders with lively and expressive animation, but Miles Morales is based in a mostly realistic world, and yet it still contains that same format of being like a vivid cartoon. I found every battle to be different, not only due to how the mechanics from the original and the new mechanics boost the overall choices one has in the gameplay, but also due to the satisfying animations that really make every action feel deliberate and satisfying. You get tons of different results when you mix up your moves and abilities, all of which make you feel as if you're watching a Spider-Man movie and seeing something intentionally set up to feel heroic and fluid by the director, except you are instead in control of every last one of Miles' actions. You truly get empowered by this system, which perfectly balances out the gameplay choices you're given, as well as the amazing animations to create a surreal, practically artistic humanity within the game. The game feels like a best friend you can always rely on for a great time and a completely unique experience. The way each area feels completely different can be attributed to the stellar way the game slowly introduces new moves and mechanics, but also due to the variety of looks within the world of New York City. The secrets you discover through the game open up new paths and areas that are foreign to Miles and certainly to the player, so it's great that the game delivers on making each one different, wacky, and beautiful all at the same time. From Roxxon's sleek yet ominous labs that represent the disgusting secret behind their frail, heroic veil, to the iconic and striking streets of New York City coated in fresh, crisp snowflakes. Each new place you go to really feels fresh and different, even though the game reuses the map from Spider-Man PS4. This is mostly because a lot of the game takes place inside of buildings or in rich brand new locales that aren't in the open world map. This helps to make it a bit of an easier game for Insomniac to have developed, but still just as interesting in terms of variety. You also have a huge variety of things you can pull off when it comes to your personal gameplay experiences, whether that be the new ultra-fluid trick system that adds a ton of fun and challenge to the web swinging, or the absolutely awesome venom and camouflage powers during combat and stealth. You really have an endless amount of awesome combos and tricks to go through. We have every last mechanic from the previous game here, and most of the same enemy types are also there, but with so much more. The Venom powers alone sold me on this game, with the different ways they adapt to the type, location, amount, and weapon of each enemy, and just how cool they look. I mean, goddamn, just look at that! You get the ability to pull off practically anything in one awesome combo with these moves, as you can now more easily jump from one enemy to the other, handle crowd control, and knock out a single enemy swiftly. You even get the chance to use these in traversal, which really is awesome because they help build up speed and height, which are made more difficult to obtain in this game as well. The XP you use for them is also done by doing tricks, which is just a stellar combination. The camouflage helps to make the stealth more fair, and also gives you the ability to slip back into stealth if you're smart about it. On the harder difficulties, these enemy bases can really kick your butt. So going back into hiding is a true lifesaver. That's really fun to perfect the technique of. The way you're allowed to approach each encounter screams freedom louder than William Wallace on his deathbed.
Prisoner wishes to say a word.
You truly have nothing weighing you down, and though the game is quite challenging in a good way, you still feel unlimited. You feel powerful, awesome, and absolutely throughout the campaign. And though you feel carefree while experiencing the refined mechanics, beautiful visuals, amazing animations, and kick bleep music, you don't feel as blindly positive during the course of the game's story. More specifically on the music, we now have a lot more of a unique feel to this game's soundtrack. The music of the PS4 game was really good superhero music, and the main theme was especially uplifting, but it was still just a very typical music that one would expect from such a game. Miles Morales, on the other hand, not only has awesome instrumental tracks that perfectly fit with what's going on in the story, but also has two of my favorite songs out there, period. This Is My Time and Where We Come From are absolutely amazing songs that totally push the soundtrack into the territory of perfection. Top that off with the super tense songs that make many of the story scenes a lot more real, raw and dark, sounding similar to that of The Last of Us Part 2, and you truly have one of my favorite soundtracks out there. The only major problem I had with the original game was how the crimes were way too abundant and annoying, and does this game fix that too? Oh yeah! Crimes are now optional. Not optional for beating the game, not optional for even 100%. There's no reason to do them unless you want to get one trophy, and if you want to get it, there's just a very small amount of them that you can quickly complete, so it's no problem whatsoever. The whole design of Miles Morales really benefits from the more limited setup of the collectibles and overall side content, which feels more seamlessly connected into the story and, because there isn't as much of it, a lot more perfectly balanced than before. The story is really what makes the game better than the original. I know I've probably said that about every other single aspect of the game, but this time I really mean it, okay? Instead of the mostly black and white perspective from the original, this game adds a lot of moral complexity to the characters. The original had some really good complex messages with Martin Lee and Doc Ock, but this game really excels beyond that point with Finn. Finn is one of my favorite video game characters of all time, and the reason for that isn't because her underground tech is cool or something simple like that, no. It's because the complexity and impact she brings to the story is on par with that of Abby from Last of Us 2. Yeah, and if I'm comparing you to that, you know you did a damn good job. She's like a sister to Miles, and the corruption she's been put through due to the evil of others ends up hurting everyone, but most of all herself. Miles can't bear to witness this transformation towards his enemy, so he tries to talk to her. He tries to convince her and tries, but in the end, the only one who can redeem her is herself. She ends up sacrificing herself to save everyone else.
You give me strength, Miles. That's all a hero really is. Someone who's brave for the people they love.
It's a wonderful redemption arc that finishes off one of the most phenomenal, unique, emotionally sympathetic and fascinating characters of all time. She truly exemplifies the disconnect between Miles' innocence and the evil that pervades some people. And I don't mean that she shows that evil herself, because in the end, she's not the villain of this game. The villain of Miles Morales is the entire idea of division, hatred, and manipulation that leads to further division, hatred, and manipulation. Finn would never have done the horrible things she did as the Tinkerer if it weren't for the evil greed and selfishness of Simon Krieger and the horrific, predatory practices of the Underground. These factions, just like the WLF and Seraphites in The Last of Us 2, reflect how people can behave once vices and awful ideas start to contaminate an entire legion of people. They would never accept these evils if not for the pressure and the hope that they have due to the presence of others, that they believe they can trust. This evil only happens when we stop fighting against those who are already contaminated with it. We need to prevent this greediness, this hatred, and this manipulation from pervading people, and the only way we can do that is to never give up. As Spider-Man always does, we have to prioritize the protection and humanity of people, rather than hating them. We have to understand why they do what they do, and Finn represents this perfectly. We don't hate the Finn that was best friends with Miles, who just wanted to be a scientist, but we do hate the Finn who wasn't going to listen, and nearly destroys all of Harlem. This is the way the game truly excels in the storytelling department. It never stops pushing new, realistic character development your way. We see the lives of these characters without explicit context, instead knowing who they are simply through the way their emotions are subtly expressed. The story here really does an amazing job showcasing the emotions of its characters and the way Spider-Man's morals help protect the world from a cycle of negativity. He rescues tons of people from fires, criminals, evil corporations, and supervillains, but the greatest rescue he provides is from being blinded. Blinded by what Roxxon did to your brother. Blinded by the identity of someone close to you. Blinded by the excuse of family. Or blinded by an all-encompassing feeling of loss. All of these simply add up to give us one of the greatest stories ever told. And with the amazing themes, characters such as the Prowler, Miles' mom, Finn, and Simon Krieger, a banging soundtrack, free and blissful gameplay, gorgeous graphics and animation, and a true passion in every inch of the game, Miles Morales is a masterpiece. Here we go, got my position, let's hit the road. Came along, now my people here with me, I'm in my zone. Been around a block of time or two, I tell you where to go, I tell you how to move. That's my attitude. Looking back, I know they probably doubt me. Now the city on my back, I wear it proudly. I'm a hero in the making. If I'm dreaming, you can't wake me. I think I'm destined to win it. Ain't playing games, I ain't in it. Yeah, yeah. I took the message and sent it. Felt like I was born for this minute. This is my time. I'm seizing the moment, cause I gotta go for the time's gone. Ain't scared of the dark, cause I'm bringing the light with a nice long. I shine on. Coming, I don't need a sign. This the moment, I'ma make it mine. This is my time.
Spider-Man.
This is my time. I'm seizing the moment, cause I gotta go for the time.